Because of the obvious threat to untold numbers of citizens, and because of the crisis which is even now developing, this radio station will remain on the air day and night. This station and hundreds of other radio and TV stations throughout this part of the country are pooling their resources through an emergency network hookup to keep you informed of all developments. At this hour, we repeat, these are the facts as we know them. There is an epidemic of mass murder being committed by a virtual army of unidentified assassins. The murders are taking place in villages, cities, rural homes, and suburbs with no apparent pattern or reason for the slayings. It seems to be a sudden, general explosion of mass homicide. We have some descriptions of the assassins. Eyewitnesses say they are ordinary-looking people. Some say they appear to be in a kind of trance. Others describe them as being... So, at this point, there is no really authentic way for us to say who or what to look for and guard yourself against. Misshapen monsters. Reaction of law enforcement officials is one of complete bewilderment at this hour. So far, we have been unable to determine that any kind of organized investigation is yet underway. Police, sheriff deputies, and emergency ambulances are literally deluged with calls for help. And the scene can best be described as mayhem. Mayors of Pittsburgh, Philadelphia, and Miami, along with the governors of several eastern and midwestern states, have indicated the National Guard may be mobilized at any moment, but that has not happened as yet. The only advice our reporters have been able to get from official sources is for private citizens to stay in their homes behind locked doors. Do not venture outside for any reason until the nature of this crisis has been determined and until we can advise what course of action to take. Keep listening to radio and TV for any special instructions as this crisis develops further. Thousands of office and factory workers are being urged to stay at their places of employment, not to make any attempt to get to their homes. However, in spite of this urging and warning, streets and highways are packed with frantic people trying to raise their families or apparently to flee just anywhere. We repeat, the safest course of action at this time is simply to stay where you are. In our newsroom. Latest word also from National Press Services in Washington, D.C. now tells us that the emergency presidential conference, which we've just mentioned, will include high-ranking scientists from the National Aeronautics and Space Administration. That's the extent of this latest bulletin. Repeating, members of his cabinet, the FBI, the Joint Chiefs of Staff, and scientists from NASA within the hour. All radio and TV stations throughout this part of the country, including the one to which you're listening, have joined their facilities in an emergency network to bring you this news as it develops. We urge you to stay tuned to radio and TV and to stay indoors at all costs. Late reports reaching this newsroom tell of frightened people seeking refuge in churches, schools, and government buildings, demanding shelter and protection from the wholesale murder which apparently is engulfing much of the nation. Law enforcement officials are at a loss to explain or, even at this hour, even to theorize about the reasons for this wave of murder. So far, the advice they're able to give the public is some of the reports of Police Chief T.K. Dunmore of Camden, North Carolina, who's quoted as saying, quote, "Tell the people for God's sake to get off the streets. Tell them to go home and lock their doors and windows up tight. We don't know what kind of murder-happy characters we have here." End quote. Police Chief Dunmore of Camden, North Carolina. So far, the only descriptions, the only clues anyone has of the killers come from frightened witnesses to some of the slayings. These eyewitness accounts variously describe the murderers as ordinary-looking people, misshapen monsters, people who look like they're in a trance, and things that look like people but act like animals. Some eyewitnesses tell of seeing victims who look as though they had been torn apart. This whole ghastly story began developing 2 days ago with a report of the slaying of a family of seven in their rural home near Cardille. D.C. Since then, reports of such senseless killings began snowballing in a reign of terror which has hopscotched in an erratic, disconnected manner throughout much of the eastern and midwestern United States. Efforts to keep track of the murder reports by the placing of markers on a map seem to indicate a general spreading from the extreme southeastern United States to the north and west. Our newsmen have been on the telephone talking with officials in other cities and have determined that none of this kind of mass murder has yet been reported west of the Mississippi River, except in the extreme southeastern portion of Texas. Similar killings have been reported around the Houston and Galveston areas, but nothing like...
I found the gun and some bullets out there.
It was only late yesterday...
On these.
...it became clear we were facing some kind of national emergency. When first reports began filtering in, newsmen and law enforcement agencies were of the opinion...
This place is boarded up pretty solid now.
...in nature. However, as these...
We ought to be all right here for a while.
...dramatically, it was soon apparent that...
We have a gun and bullets, food and the radio.
...began to suspect an obscure kind of conspiracy.
Sooner or later, someone's bound to come and get us out.
...creatures from outer space. So again, we join with law enforcement agencies in urging you to seek shelter in a building. Lock the doors and windows securely.
Hey, that's us. We're doing all right.
...cautious of any suspicious strangers. And keep tuned to your radio and television for survival instructions and further details of this continuing story.
Look, I don't know if you're hearing me, but I'm going upstairs now. If anything should try to break in here, I can hear it from up there. I'll be down to take care of it. Everything is all right for now. I'll be back to reinforce the windows and doors later. But you'll be all right for now, okay? Okay.
Civil defense officials in Cumberland have told newsmen that murder victims show evidence of having been partially devoured by their murderers. Reports from witnesses to the effect that people who acted as though they were in a kind of trance were killing and eating their victims prompted authorities to examine the bodies of some of the victims. Medical authorities in Cumberland have concluded that in all cases, the killers are eating the flesh of the people they murder. Repeating this latest bulletin just received moments ago from Cumberland, Maryland, civil defense authorities have told newsmen that murder victims show evidence of having been partially devoured by their murderers. Medical examination of victims' bodies shows conclusively that the killers are eating the flesh of the people they kill. And so this incredible story becomes more ghastly with each report. It's difficult to imagine such a thing actually happening, but these are the reports we have been receiving and passing on to you, reports which have been verified as completely as is possible in this confused situation. It is happening, and it would appear that no one is safe from this wave of mass murder.
Don't shoot! We're from town!
City, a radio!
County, Pennsylvania. The Butler County Sheriff has verified that reports of murder victims being partially eaten by their slayers is true. No further details available at this time. However,
how long you guys been down there? I could use some help up here.
That's the cellar. It's the safest place.
You mean you didn't hear the racket we were making up here?
How are we supposed to know what was going on? Could have been those things for all we knew.
That girl was screaming. Sure, you must know what a girl screaming sounds like. Those things don't make any noise. Anybody would know somebody ever needed help.
Look, it's kind of hard to hear what's going on from down there.
We thought we could hear screams, but for all we knew, that could have meant those things were in the house afterward.
And you wouldn't come up and help.
Well, if there were more...
The racket sounded like the place was being ripped apart. How were we supposed to know what was going on?
Now, wait a minute. You just got finished saying you couldn't hear from down there. Now you say it sounded like the place was being ripped apart. It would be nice if you'd get your story straight, man.
All right, now you tell me. I'm not going to take that kind of a chance when we got a safe place. We luck into a safe place, and you're telling us we got to risk our lives just because somebody might need help, huh?
Yeah, something like that.
All right, why don't we settle this?
Mister, we came up. Okay, we're here. Now I suggest we all go back downstairs before any of those things find out we're in here.
They can't get in here.
You got the whole place boarded up?
Yeah, most of it. All but a few spots upstairs. They won't be hard to fix.
You're insane. The cellar's the safest place.
I'm telling you, they can't get in here.
And I'm telling you, those things turned over our car. We were damn lucky to get away at all. Now you tell me those things can't get through this lousy pile of wood?
His wife and kids downstairs. The kids hurt.
Well, I still think we're better off up here.
We could strengthen everything up, Mr. Cooper.
With all of us working, we could fix this place up in no time. We have everything we need up here.
We can take all that stuff downstairs with us. Man, you're really crazy, you know that? You got a million windows up here. All these windows, you're gonna make them strong enough to keep these things out, huh?
I told you, those things don't have any strength. I smashed three of them and pushed another one out the door.
Did you hear me when I told you they turned over our car?
Oh, hell, any good 5 men can do that.
That's my point. Only there's not going to be 5 or even 10. There's going to be 20, 30, maybe 100 of those things. And as soon as they know we're here, this place is going to be crawling with them.
Well, if they're that many, they'll probably get us wherever we are.
Look, the cellar. The cellar, there's only one door, right? Just one door, that's all we have to protect. Tom and I fixed it so it locks and boards from the inside. But up here, all these windows, why, we'd never know where they were going to hit us next.
You got a point, Mr. Cooper. But down in the cellar, there's no place to run to. I mean, if they did get in, there'd be no back exit. We'd be done for. We can get out of here if we have to. And we got windows to see what's going on outside. But down there with no windows, if a rescue party did come, we wouldn't even know it.
But the cellar is the strongest place.
The cellar is a death trap.
I don't know, Mr. Cooper. I think he's right. You know how many's out there?
I don't know. Maybe 6 or 7.
Look. You two can do whatever you like. I'm going back down to the cellar, and you better decide. Because I'm going to board up that door, and I'm not going to unlock it again, no matter what happens.
Now, wait a minute, Mr. Cooper.
No, I'm not going to wait. I've made my decision, now you make yours.
Now, wait a minute. Let's think about this. We can make it to the cellar if we have to. And if we do decide to stay down there, we'll need some things from up here. So let's at least consider this a while.
If you box yourself in the cellar and those things get in the house, you've had it. At least up here you have a fighting chance.
Yeah, it looks like about 8 or 10 out there now.
That's more than there were. There are a lot out back, too.
Fix these boards.
You're crazy. Those things are going to be in every window and door in this place. We've got to get down into the cellar.
Go down in that damn cellar. Get out of here!
I'm taking the girl with me.
You leave her here.
Keep your hands off her. And everything else that's up here, too. Because if I stay up here, I'm fighting for everything up here. And the radio and the food is part of what I'm fighting for. Now, if you're going down the cellar, get.
The man's insane. He's insane. We've got to have food down there. We've got a right.
This is your house.
We've got a right.
You going down there with him?
Well,
yes or no, this is your last chance. No beating around the bush.
Listen, I got a kid down there. She can't possibly, I couldn't bring her up here. She can't possibly take all the racket and those things smashing through the windows.
Well, you're her father. If you're stupid enough to go die in that trap, that's your business. However, I am not stupid enough to follow you. It is tough for the kid that old man is so stupid. Now, you get the hell down in the cellar. You can be the boss down there. I'm boss up here.
You bastards. You know, I won't open this door again. I mean it.
Mr. Cooper, with your help, we can...
With my help.
Let him go, man. His mind is made up. Just let him go.
Wait a minute. Judy, come on up here, honey.
You're gonna let them get hurt too, huh?
It's all right, honey. Go ahead. Together, man, we can fix it up real good. There's lots of places we can run to up here. Mr. Cooper, we'd all be a lot better off if all three of us were working together.
Hey, kid.
He's wrong, you know. I'm not boxing myself in down there.
Well, we're safe now. It's boarded up tight.
What about Tom and Judy?
They want to stay up there, let them. There are two other people upstairs, a man and a girl.
We heard the screaming.
Yeah, but I didn't know who they were, and I wasn't about to take any unnecessary chances.
Of course not, Harry.
Is she all right?
I don't know what it is. She feels warm. Maybe it's shock.
Where'd you get the bandage?
Some laundry in a basket. I tore a sheet.
Let them stay upstairs. Let them. Too many ways those monsters can get in up there. We'll see who's right. We'll see when they come begging me to let them in down here.
That's important, isn't it?
What?
To be right, everybody else to be wrong.
What do you mean by that?
Does anyone up there know why we're being attacked?
Whatever it isn't just happening here. It's some kind of mass murder. It's going on everywhere. The radio said to stay inside.
Radio?
Radio upstairs. I heard a news bulletin.
There's a radio upstairs and you boarded us in down here?
I know what I'm doing.
What did it say?
Nothing. Nothing. They don't know anything yet. There's mass murder everywhere and people are supposed to look for a safe place to hide.
Take the boards off that door.
We are staying down here, Helen.
Harry, that radio is at least some kind of communication. If the authorities know what's happening, well, they'll send people for us or they'll tell us what to do. How are we going to know what's going on if we lock ourselves in this dungeon? We may not enjoy living together, but dying together isn't going to solve anything. Those people aren't our enemies.
Mr. Cooper, Ben found a television set upstairs.
Let's go up. Tom?
Yes?
If Judy would come downstairs for a few minutes, Harry and I could come upstairs.
Okay, yeah, right away.
Will you do it?
Do I have to?
Look, honey, nothing's gonna get done with them down there and us up here. Do this for me.
Okay.
Okay, open up.
Upstairs now.
Her brother was killed. I gotta go help Ben with the television.
Don't be afraid of me. I'm Helen Cooper, Harry's wife.
This place is ridiculous. Look at this. There's a million weak spots up here. Give me one of those.
Her brother was killed.
Windows. I can't see a damn thing. There could be 50 million of those things out there. That's how much good these windows are.
Why don't you do something to help somebody?
Here, I have it. Drag a couple of those chairs together.
There's a socket over here.
You better watch this and try to understand what's going on. I don't want anyone's life on my hands.
Is there anything I can do to
help? I don't want to hear any more from you, mister. If you stay up here, you take orders from me. And that includes leaving the girl alone.
It's on. It's on.
There's no sound. Play with the rabbit ears.
Reports, incredible as they seem, are not the results of mass hysteria.
Mass hysteria. What do they think? We're imagining all this?
Shut up!
In all parts of the country. The wave of murder which is sweeping the eastern third of the nation is being committed by creatures who feast upon the flesh of their victims. First eyewitness accounts of this grisly development came from people who were understandably frightened and almost incoherent. Officials and newsmen at first discounted those eyewitness descriptions as being beyond belief. However, the reports persisted. Medical examinations of some of the victims bore out the fact that they had been partially devoured. I think we have some late word of just arriving, and I'll interrupt to bring this to you. This is the latest disclosure in a report from National Civil Defense Headquarters in Washington. It has been established that persons who have recently died have been returning to life and committing acts of murder. A widespread investigation of reports from funeral homes, morgues, and hospitals has concluded that the unburied dead are coming back to life and seeking human victims. It's hard for us here to believe what we're reporting to you, but it does seem to be a fact. When this emergency first began, radio and television was advising people to stay inside, behind locked doors, for safety. Well, that situation has now changed. We're able to report a definite course of action for you. Civil defense machinery has been organized to provide rescue stations with food, shelter, medical treatment, and protection by armed National Guardsmen. Stay tuned to the broadcasting stations in your local area for this list of rescue stations. This list will be repeated throughout our news coverage. Look for the name of the rescue station nearest you and make your way to that location as soon as possible.
So we have that truck. If we can get some gas, we can get out of here.
There's a pump out by the shed.
I know that's why I pulled in here, but it's locked.
Called this afternoon by the president. Since convening this conference of the presidential cabinet, the FBI, the Joint Chiefs of Staff, the CIA, has not produced any public information. Why are space experts being consulted about an earthbound emergency? Well, so far, all the betting on the answer to that question centers on the recent Explorer satellite shot to Venus. That satellite, you recall, started back to Earth, but never got here. That's the space vehicle which orbited Venus and then was purposely destroyed by NASA when scientists discovered it was carrying a mysterious high-level radiation with it. Could that radiation be somehow responsible for the wholesale murders we're now suffering? Newsman Don Quinn in Washington has posed those questions.
It's obvious our best move is to try to get out of here.
How are you going to get over to that pump? Look!
You're coming from a meeting regarding the explosion of the Venus probe, is that right?
Yes, that was the subject of the meeting.
You feel there is a connection between this and the phenomenon?
There's a definite connection. A definite connection.
In other words, you feel that the radiation on the Venus probe is enough to cause these mutations?
There was a very high degree of radiation.
Well, just a minute. I'm not sure that that's certain at all. I don't think that has been
irrefutably proved that we have at this time.
In other words, it is the military's viewpoint that the radiation is not the cause of the mutation.
I can't speak for the entire military at this time, gentlemen. I must disagree with these gentlemen presently until this is irrefutably proved.
Everything is being done that can be done.
We'll have to hurry for our next meeting.
Professor, you feel that there is a definite connection between
the definite connection as far as Dr. Keller and myself.
Doctor, please. I thought we decided that is not proved yet.
When the satellite was exploded?
An unusual amount of radiation, enough to cause mutation under certain circumstances.
Could have happened to
have a bearing on it.
It does seem to have a bearing. Yes.
Will there be a reply for the
later?
Yes.
There will be a reply.
Yes.
Later this afternoon. There will be a report this afternoon.
Perhaps there will be a report.
Yes.
A later report.
Will you close the window?
We are doing everything possible to solve the problem.
We're hoping to get some further explanation of this.
We've heard all we need to know. We have to try to get out of here.
He said the rescue stations have doctors and medical supplies. If we could get Karen there, we could get help for her.
Elmo is one of the world's foremost authorities on space science and technology.
Willard. I saw a sign that said Willard.
It's only about 17 miles from here.
You know this area. You from around here?
Judy and I are both from around here. We were on our way up to the lake to go swimming. And Judy had a radio, and we heard the first reports about this. So we knew the old house was here, and we came in and found the lady upstairs dead. Then these other people came. We went down into the basement and put a bar across the door, and it is pretty strong.
How could we possibly get away from here? We've got a sick child, two women, one woman out of her head, three men, and the place is surrounded with these things.
Dr. Grimes, your entire staff, I know, has been working very hard to find some solution to these things that are happening. Do you have any answers at this time?
Yes, we have some answers. But first, let me stress the importance of seeking medical attention for anyone who's been injured in any way. We don't know yet what complications might result from such injuries.
How bad has your kid been hurt?
Good advice, Doctor. Now, how about the basic problem of patients?
Well, look, you go down there and tell... And then Judy? Yeah, you tell Judy to come up here and you stay with the kid, all right?
In the cold room at the university, we had a cadaver. A cadaver from which all four limbs had been amputated. Sometime early this morning, it opened its eyes and began to move its trunk. It was dead, but it opened its eyes and tried to move.
They want you upstairs. Did she ask for me?
She hasn't said anything.
I don't understand. Baby. It's Mommy.
I heard. I'll come back down as soon as I find out what they want.
Thank you, Judy.
The body should be disposed of at once, preferably by cremation.
Well, how long after death, then, does the body become reactivated?
It's only a matter of minutes.
Minutes? Well, that doesn't give people time to make any arrangements.
No, you're right. It doesn't give them time to make funeral arrangements. The bodies must be carried to the street and burned. They must be burned immediately. Soak them with gasoline and burn them. The bereaved will have to forego the dubious comforts that a funeral service will give. They're just dead flesh and dangerous.
I see.
Judy, I need you to find some bedspreads or sheets to tear up into small strips, okay? Is there a fruit cellar here?
Yes.
We need some bottles or jars to make Molotov cocktails and hold them off while we try to escape.
Hey, there's a big can of kerosene down there.
I'll see what I can find.
I'll look for the bottles. There's a big key ring down there. There may be a key to the gas pump on it. I'll check.
We can toss the cocktails from a window upstairs. In the meantime, a couple of us can go out and try to get the gas and come back for the rest of the people.
But that'll leave a door open someplace.
Yeah, that's right. It better be this door. It's closer to the truck. Before we go out, we'll put some supplies behind the cellar door. While we're gone, the rest of you can hold up in there.
I found some fruit jars in the cellar. And there's a key on here that's labeled for the gas pump out back.
I'm not really that used to the truck. I found it abandoned.
I can handle the truck, no sweat.
You're it, then. You and I.